Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're going to be doing a vegetable dish today. A lot of vegetable dishes are kind of boring, so what I'm going to do is make broccoli and cauliflower with a nice cheese sauce. What I've chosen here are broccoli cuts. You can see just a frozen bunch of broccoli cuts, nice and green. And then we have cauliflower, which is frozen, and these are about equally sized. What I'm going to do is to just dump the cauliflower into one of these pots back here. I have about an inch worth of water boiling rapidly at this point. When I put this in, of course, it will stop boiling, so I'll need to bring it back up to a boil. And both of these, the cauliflower and the broccoli, will be boiling for about 6 to 8 minutes. So I put this one in, and I don't need to reduce the heat at this point. Later on, if it's boiling really hard, then I might want to reduce the heat. So we've got that started, and then we want the other one cooking at the same time. So I'm putting all of this package of broccoli cuts. And if you're not sure about how much you need to put in, it just depends on how much you're gonna have a need for with your dinner. You could just put half of a bag in, or you could cook it all and then just use half for your serving portions. But this needs to cook for about 6 to 8 minutes after it comes back to a boil. So I'll be back with you and we'll work on the cheese sauce. Now we're going to go to the broccoli and the cauliflower, which have been cooking about 6 minutes. We don't want to overcook them. I'm going to turn them off, and I have been checking on them. So there goes that one, and there goes the other one. What I want to do is to immediately drain these. You do not want to overcook them, and they will continue to cook if you let them sit in that hot water. So we have this one, and I just typically put the colander right back over the saucepan. And we'll put that right there in order to work with it. The broccoli should look nice and green. You don't want it olive colored. That would mean that you've cooked it too long. So let's drain that down the sink and put the colander back on top so we can work with this one. So now we have our two vegetables that we're going to combine, and I'm going to need a utensil that will handle them pretty easily. So I've got this, which kind of drains them, make sure that I don't have any excess water in this serving bowl. In the meantime, while you were away, I was making some cheese sauce. I've already got it made, and I've got it over the warmer burner here. And you can see it's the very same cheese sauce that we made when we did Betty's creamy cooktop macaroni and cheese. Very same recipe, so if you want to go and look at that video, you'll find out how to make the cheese sauce. That's going to be crucial to this recipe. Also, what I've done is to brown up some almond slices in a small skillet. I used about a half a tablespoon of margarine, melted it, and then I added the almond slices, and it took about 30 seconds for them to crisp up like this. And actually, even taking it off the heat and letting it set, it turned them browner. So you really want to watch them carefully that they don't get too brown and are burned and bitter. So these look nice. You need to drain them because of that margarine that they are kind of saturated in. So let's just put them on a little dish right here, where we have paper towel to absorb that extra grease. Now coming over here, what I'd like to do is intermingle these without mashing or crushing them up. So I'm just gonna take a little bit from each and sort of mix them and continue until I have as much as I would like to have in that bowl. And I can make adjustments as I go along. If I see that I've got a little bit too much white in one section, then I'll put some green there next time. And you know the two packages were roughly the same size. I didn't really check to see how many ounces they were, but when I write up the recipe, I will check to see how many ounces we were using for each one. So you may be filling your bowl entirely, or you may just want part of this, but when it gets to the point where you're ready to say, that's it, then stop filling, and we'll remove these over here in the sink area. And then grab our cheese sauce, turn that off now. And you have some choices here. What you might do is put the cheese sauce over the top as much as you want and then stir it all together. So you have a nice creamy dish, a vegetable dish that has a nice cheese sauce to it. Another option is to ladle as much as you want over the top, kind of in a direction that you like. The handles are here, you might want to go vertically with the handles. And then on top of that will go the almonds. Or if you prefer, what you may do is on your serving plate, lift out as much as you want for your portion or for some guest, and then allow them to choose whether they want the topping or if they would like to let it go. To serve the topping here, you just take some cheese sauce and, well, I was going to ladle it into my pitcher here to make this a little more elegant because I don't serve at the table from those pots, but just imagine that you've got it in this pitcher. I think I'll put a little in there just to show you. And I would fill that fuller if I had more time. But you could just pour it easily. If you don't want to pour it, then you could spoon it. But the idea is just to give some coverage to that portion of cauliflower and broccoli. Now going back to the topping, since I have chosen to make this an individual serving, I'll just take a few of these and probably would use a spoon instead of my fingers. I just have all my spoons tied up right now. So going across the top, putting a little bit along. It just makes it look nice and inviting. And that's half the battle. If you're trying to get people in your family to eat vegetables, sometimes if you'll do a trick like this, then it'll be a lot more appealing. So this is my cauliflower and broccoli with cheese sauce recipe.